It's funny. Immediately after what happened last night, I got a text from my mother. And it had asked if, well, first of all, she said, "Wow, that was really great." But then she asked if I'm sad the season's over. Well, if I had to pick a low for today, that would have to be it. Because I did not want this season to end whatsoever. My high is that I got to experience something fun. Just pure, unadulterated, straight up fun. And honestly, when it comes to watching a show like The Masked Singer, or really any show that you like, if you're not having fun doing it, then there's something wrong. And I don't think the show, and the show may not be the problem. Therefore, I gotta say right now, I want spring to come here as soon as possible. Which, you know what, I'd show you how bad it is out right now, but I'll put it this way. All schools are closed in my area. Like Horseheads, Corning, Elmira, all of them, they are closed. Like, in case you probably could have figured out from what I just said, we just had a massive snowstorm last night. Actually, it started yesterday afternoon. It was so bad, no kidding, I actually almost crashed. Not like on purpose or anything, it's the sort of thing like where you brake and like I wouldn't slow in because it's so slick out, I had to stop. If I didn't swerve my car out of the way, I would have hit somebody. That's how bad it was. I'm way back here. So, I mean, pretty obvious. I'm fine. I'm safe. But I'm actually starting this video a little earlier than normal, just so if I have to be anywhere at all, like I leave as soon as possible. In fact, I may wind up getting my day really, really, really started the instant I stop recording this video. I mean, I'm still gonna try and upload it before I go anywhere, but it's crazy out there, man. That it's still snowing. It's not like gigantic snowflakes or the really, really tiny snowflakes, but due to like, it's like the effect of like the wind and the fact that this particular wind always makes like the whoo sound. Like, it's really sort of adding to what we're getting, So, yep. Needless to say, I'm probably gonna have to be visiting my folks in the near future and shovel their driveway. I don't mind doing that though. I like shoveling the driveway. Shoveling the driveway is awesome. Seriously, my brother and I were growing up, there was a time we really, really, really looked forward to doing it. And, if I'm gonna visit my, and if I visit my folks during this time of year and I'll see y'all throughout the winter and I see snow, sure, I'll shovel it. Why not? It's fun to do. Especially since my father came up with a really intricate system to get it done. Well, I say intricate. What he does is he'll go, cause, you have your like standard, hold on. I'll talk about the rest. I gotta talk about act of kindness first. So what was my act of kindness yesterday? Well, really up until the snowstorm. Well, I got to visit my grandmother and before the snowstorm hit, she wanted to get the water from Tops. It's a supermarket chain. So I got her water. And yeah. Actually, I'm not gonna lie, when it comes to the packaging, Tops is really good. Cause my grandmother has like the bottles of water that are like this big. Like that's yes, my head is huge. No. Well, technically I do kind of have a big head, but like the bottles of water, like yay big. and you get like 24 or 30 of them or something. I forgot how many. But I got like three packages of those. They don't really come in like two packs or whatever. Some places have like their store water and they come in like two packs, but Tops doesn't really do that, which it's fine, you know. Actually, carrying three of those things is surprisingly really light. Honestly, it's not that they're heavy if you have to carry like multiple ones of those things, but because you need both of your hands to carry it, if you have like to open the door, it's hard to do. So yeah, ran a quick little errand for my grandma. Good morning and happy Thursday, everybody. So back to where I was about shoveling my folks' driveway. My father has an intricate system where, and again, you have your standard, like, straight driveway. There's no twists and turns or, you know, any of that stuff, right? What my father will do, he'll get into the center of my driveway, take the shovel, and just go right down the middle to the end of the driveway, out in the middle of the road. See, his logic is, you know, a plow is going to come anyway and get that part of the driveway snow that's in the road. So there's no problem with that. So with this system, he's at the other end of the driveway. And what he does is he looks to his left, shovels to the other side, looks to his right, shoveling the other side, like back and forth and back and forth, just going up that middle. You see, when you make like a long, narrow sort of thing, you're able to walk through it, you know? It's actually really fun and simple to do. Then he'll, that's the system I imply when I do that very thing. So when I shovel the driveway. So yeah. Although now that I think about it, considering the snowstorm we just had, the possibility of a white Christmas is most imminent. Well, you have, actually, Christmas is 1 week, well, 1 week from tomorrow. Yeah, Christmas Eve is gonna be Christmas Eve is 1 week from today, is a Thursday. And, yeah, I said this already before, but Christmas Day will be the last Friday of 2020. You know what, considering the year we've had, a really important holiday like Christmas, you know, I'll take that for the year we've had. Sure. And, you know, even though, yes, we are in the middle of a pandemic, which, you know, from what I hear, the vaccine is about done and everyone's getting vaccinated as soon as possible. You know, it still follows the same guidelines. I mean, you know, you have a holiday where most people take off on a Friday. You know, you have the weekend to, you know, relax and have fun. And that's pretty much what I'm going to be wind up doing that upcoming weekend. And, well, I'm going to be relaxing this weekend too, but, I mean, nothing's really going on this week. Next week, though, you know, you have Christmas. And then the Monday after is my birthday. I'm excited. I'm going to be turning 31. I'm not worried. I mean, Everyone already dreads turning 30s, and I am already 30, so I'm not complaining. I'm fine. That being said, though, I know that at some point my family is going to want to get together to celebrate my birthday. Personally, here's my rule of thumb. Because actually, I would rather have this. I would rather wait until we're well into the new year before we get together to celebrate my birthday. Just because, especially with this year being my birthday being on Monday, I don't want to celebrate my birthday the weekend before, like, my birthday would be on that Monday. So the weekend after Christmas, you know, Saturday's the 26th, you know, Sunday's the 27th, Monday the 28th, that's my birthday. I don't want to do that. Personally, I'd rather, like, we wait until at least the new year begins, or maybe, like, the weekend after New Year's. So, or the first full week after New Year's. So New Year's Day is going to be on Friday. So not that weekend, but the weekend after. So the weekend of the 9th and 10th, maybe. That's fair. That's a good time to do it. You know, it's nothing too stressful, nothing too cumbersome. You know, everyone's had some time to sort of adjust into what the new year has in store. And, you know, it's a way to, you know, get to that first little chunk of the new year before things really rev up, because, you know, things really are heading towards us that are on the major side after Christmas and New Year's. I mean, we're slowly but surely getting to that time of year where I will stress on every Friday video that if you want to have meat on Fridays and you're a Christian, if you're a Christian or a Catholic and you like having meat on Fridays, you better get your fill in now, because once Lent starts, you know, you're not going to be able to have that. You know, I actually, it's sad. I did look up when Lent starts next year. Actually, I'll look it up again. Why not? Let's see. Oh, February 27th. That's early. So, yeah. It's going to be like very early April, late March when we have Easter. And I just realized I should have been talking about the Masked Singer the entire time. I'm sorry. It's just, I really don't know what to say about the Masked Singer other than, like, I had a load of fun. Nick Carter, who came in third place as the Crocodile, he was great. Allo Black, I think that's how you say his name. You know, the runner-up as the Mushroom, you know, he was fantastic. But I need to take this last part to talk about the Sun. I really, really need to talk about the Sun here. Who was Leanne Rimes? Now, I honestly never know who any of these people are. But for those of you who do not know, Leanne Rimes is a singer and songwriter who actually rose to stardom at like a very early age. She was actually the youngest person to ever win a Grammy. And it's so bizarre sometimes. Like, these are people that, by all accounts, maybe I should know, but I don't. Because I actually looked her up. I'm actually looking her up right now. I actually have the information on, you know, on my computer that I'm looking at. She's only 38 years old. She's really not that much older than I am. I'm going to be turning 31 in 11 days from now. Which reminds me, believe it or not, today, on this day, in 1989, the very first episode of The Simpsons premiered. Yeah. I'm being serious. The Simpsons Roasting on Open Fire was the very first episode of The Simpsons, and it premiered on this day in 1989. And 11 days later, I was born. So yes, The Simpsons is older than I am. Cool. Right, but let's talk about actually, you know what? The Masked Singer is a Fox show, so yeah, it fits. So with that being said, what can I tell you? Leanne Rimes, you know, as the Sun, she was unbelievable. And you know what? I actually thought of this morning before I started recording this. There's actually a metaphor here. There is. See, Leanne Rimes was the Sun, as I've just stated. I find it very, very, very fitting that, like the course of a day, and considering the time of year, and considering that we're already very in late December, you know, you could argue that this time of year, that throughout the course of a year, much like the sun rising and setting throughout the course of a day, it's very fitting that season four of The Masked Singer began with the Sun's first performance. And it ended with the Sun's unmasking as her as the winner. I don't know. I actually find it very fitting that that's how it ended. I mean, yeah, I know. I've been saying that the Sun was going to win the entire time. And to be perfectly honest, a part of me really is glad I'm right. But believe it or not, it actually goes with something that the Grand Line Review once talked about as to why he doesn't come up with theories and why we all really shouldn't come up with theories about anything, really. Because if it's a theory about a story or like a narrative or a franchise, let's say that you're right. Yeah, technically you get bragging rights, but when you think about it, you spoil the ending for yourself. I didn't even think of it that way. But technically that's what happens. No, and don't get me wrong. If I went by that logic, I wouldn't be able to enjoy even half. I mean, don't get me wrong, regardless of whether I believe that or not, it doesn't take away from my enjoyment of last night at all. I had a blast watching it. So to all the contestants of The Masked Singer, and of course to the lovely and talented Leanne Rimes, the artist formerly known as The Sun, as Nick Cannon would say, thank you. Actually, you know what? Also to the judges, Nick Cannon, and you know everyone involved with The Masked Singer, thank you. You know, with 2020 being the year that it was, and with it winding down, you gave us something really special this holiday season. So thank you. Like, favorite, share, hit the subscribe button, follow me on social media platforms, trying to get on YouTube. I'm very humbled to make this video for all of you guys to watch and enjoy for today. I'm hoping you have a wonderful, wonderful Thursday. And remember, you guys, my target channel is going to be here to lend an ear. I'll always be back. Take care and make good choices. Have a nice day.